find the standard equation given the elements. Okay, so here we have to find the standard equation of the hyperbola with its center at the 1, 1 coordinate. We have a focus at 6, 1 and a vertex. So specify dito V1 siya, 5, 1. But regardless kung V1 siya or V2, hindi naman nagmamatter. Okay, so solution, magdo-drawing tayo. Okay, so for ellipse and hyperbola, just like the ellipse, ang pinaka-importante na variables are h, k. So, di ba natatandaan sa ellipse, ito yung golden. H, k, a, and b. Sa ellipse at sa hyperbola, yan palagi. Okay? So, check muna natin sa given. So, ito, mayroon din akong tuturo sa inyong technique. Association. Okay, we need to associate these variables. Take note, h, k, a, and b. Di ba yan naman yung ating hinahanap? So, paano nyo nahahanap yung H and K? So, check nyo muna sa given kung may center. If may center, automatically, that will give you H and K. If wala, ibig sabihin, magsosolve pa kayo ng H and K, which we'll have later on sa next example. But since may center siya, ibig sabihin, given si H and K. So, I have already idea na meron ng H and K. Kung focus ang given, this should give you the idea na merong C. Kung foci siya, 2C. Okay? Kung vertex naman, this should give you the idea na merong A. Kung co-vertices, merong B. Nagets ba? Like ako, nagets. Nagets yung mga given. Kung center, HK. Focus or foci, may C. Kung vertex or vertices, may A. Kung co-vertices, it's B. Okay, so meaning I have the idea na meron akong ganitong mga given. So extract muna natin by plotting the points. We have 1, 1. So 1, 1. Nerf na. 1, 1. Okay, 1, 1. We have the center here. Okay, then we have focus. 6, 1. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 1. So let's just name this one F1 kasi V1 yung isa. So syempre, likely that's F1 also. Ito. V1, 5, 1. So somewhere is V1. Okay, so always remember that the vertices will give you that, will give you the transverse axis. So meaning, if I connect the center and V1, this should give me A. Okay, this should give me A. If I connect center and focus, this should give me C because that's the focal distance. Small letter C, by the way, not the big letter C. Big letter C is the center. Okay, paano ba i-differentiate si center? Ganyan, lalagyan ko na ng line. Yan. Okay, so yan. Kakapalan ko na lang siya. So, that's the center C. Okay, so ibig sabihin, if I count the distance, this will give me this value. So, count natin yung distance sa A muna. So, for A, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So, ibig sabihin, A is 4. For C, count natin. So, basically, kung 4 to, punta sa F1, that's 5. Okay, so, yon. Ano yung mga nakuha nating elements? First, take note that the transverse axis here, or especially the semi-transverse, this is the semi-transverse A, it's horizontal. So, it should mean that your transverse axis is horizontal. Okay, so by the way, axis of symmetry of the hyperbola is the transverse axis. So, pag nakakita kayo ng books or resources, axis of symmetry ng hyperbola, sa transverse axis. So, horizontal siya. If horizontal siya, we're going to use this formula here. X minus H quantity squared over A squared. Yung una. Okay, we have focal distance C equals 5. Kinaut natin. At A, which is 4. Okay, now, if you have A and C or B and C, take note, meron tayong formula dito for focal distance. Okay, so for example, if wala si A pero may C at saka B, na extract mo siya from the given, meaning you can solve for A. So kung wala naman si B pero may C at saka may A, you can also use this focal distance formula. So to solve for B, you will use the focal distance formula, substitute the given values, C is 5, A is 4, square both sides para makancel yung square root. We have 25 equals 16 plus B squared. Then if we use transposition, you will have 25 minus 16 equals B squared, or B squared equals 25 minus 16. Diba? So 25 minus 16 is 9. Get the square root of both sides. This will give us B equals 3. So take note, positive dapat si B at saka si A kasi distances yan. Okay. Naka-follow ba? Like daw ako naka-follow. Naka-follow kayo? Naka-follow sa explanation. Okay, very good. So we have now H. So take note, may H tayo kasi H is 1. K is 1. From the center. So check na si H. Check na si K. We also have A here. Check na si A. And B. We have solved for B. Check na si B. So kung yung apat na yan, available na, it means you can solve for the equation. So we are using horizontal na equation. So yan, ilista lang natin ulit yung mga given. So horizontal siya, it follows x minus h quantity squared over a squared minus y minus k quantity squared over b squared equals 1. So if we substitute and we simplify, we will get this equation. So for this example, the answer is x minus 1 quantity squared over 16 minus y minus 1 quantity squared over 9 equals 1. Okay, so kayo na lang yung mag-check sa Desmos kung tama ba yung sagot na yan. Any questions? May questions kayo? If walang questions, heart daw, heart. Okay, so let's proceed to the third example. Okay, so find the standard equation of the hyperbola with its foci at negative 615 and negative 63, sorry, with a length of transverse axis 8 equal to 8. Okay, so again, analyze muna natin yung problem. So based sa problem, may foci. Dalawa foci, eh. So meaning I can actually search for 2C. Ano pa? We have the transverse length of the transverse axis. So length of the transverse axis based sa formula, transverse axis, so this is 2A. No, conjugate axis yan, 2B yan. So likely ito lang yung ma-extract natin na variables, A at saka C. But let's try muna, i-draw muna natin siya. So we have negative 6 and 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 15. Oops, napakataas. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So somewhere here, oops, somewhere here, at saka here. So never mind, hindi mo kailangan accurate na accurate. That's F1. F2 is negative 6, 3. So somewhere here siguro. So this is F2. Okay, so ano yung makukuha natin dito? F1 saka F2. So from F1, F2, remember, the foci is always aligned with the vertices. And the vertices are the endpoints of the transverse axis. And since if aligned siya, it means kung vertical yung line, for example, i-connect natin to. Since vertical to, the transverse axis is also vertical. Okay, so the axis of symmetry or the transverse axis is vertical. Okay, so ano pa yung makukuha natin? So check natin, di ba? Inanalyze natin kanina, 2C. So bakit 2C yan? Kasi the distance between F1 and F2, that's 2C. So if we count, distance siya, so starts sa 3. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so yan. I think it's 12. Basta i-count nyo lang ulit. Basta 12 yan. 12. So, sure akong 12 yan kasi ang difference ng 15 at saka 3 is 12 eh. 15 minus 3. Diba? Distance. 15 dito sa F1 minus 3 sa F2. That's 12. So, yung 12 dyan, that's actually 2C. So, 2C is equivalent to 12. So, this should give us the idea that C is 6. Kasi 12 divided by 2 is 6. Okay, so aside from that, we also have the transverse axis. So we just don't know asan siyang part, but we know that 2A is 8. Okay, is 8. So this should give us the idea that A is 4. Okay, so ilista natin yung H, K, A, B. Ito yung goal natin. So meron na tayong A. Wala pa tayong B, wala pa tayong H and K. So, unahin muna natin si B kasi merong C at saka merong A. So, ito ha, pag meron kang A, tapos meron kang C, or meron kang B at saka meron kang C, so you can solve for the other element. Okay, so focal distance natin is 6, A is 4. So, to solve for B, we will use the focal distance formula pa rin. Okay, and then, substitute square both sides. We have 36 equals 16 plus B squared. Use the properties of equality, transpose, tapos flip mo lang, symmetric property. You will have b squared equals 36 minus 16. 36 minus 16 is 20. Okay, so square root of both sides, we have b equals 2 square root of 5. Okay, so check na si b. Okay, now, ang problem na lang natin h and k. So here, we're not given a center. Okay, pero meron tayong idea. So dito dapat nakikinig kayo kasi ito ay analysis talaga ha. So are you still there? Like daw kung nandiyan pa kayo, check ko muna. Kailangan ko ng inyong ano, lang yung focus dito. Focus muna dito kasi dito usually nagkakamali. Okay, so we are looking for the center. And remember, the center is in the middle of F1 and F2. So basta pag given ng foci, you can also solve for the center by getting the middle point between F1 and F2. So how do we get the middle between F1 and F2? So yun ang problema, di ba? So sir, usahon man na. Okay, so basically the middle value, so take note, ang middle niya, this is actually 6. Sa value niya sa horizontal value niya, that's 6, di ba? So same sa ano, same sa foci. And kung makikita nyo, yung dalawa, may 6. Negative 6 pala siya, sorry. Not 6, but negative 6. So ano yung negative 6 dyan? Yung negative 6 dyan, since parehas, may parehas na component ang center sa F1 saka F2, yung negative 6 na yan, that's a component similar sa F1 saka F2 for the center. So in reality, since horizontal component yan, that's also our H. It's the horizontal component of the center. Nagets ba? Nagets? Like the ko nagets ninyo. Since negative 6 yung horizontal component ng F1 and F2, meaning ang horizontal component ng center is also negative 6. Kasi the same eh. Diba? So somewhere here. Siyempre, yun dyan ang ano, center. So yun ang importance ng drawing. Okay, then we have 15 and 3. So ano naman yung gamit ng 15 and 3 sa foci? So yung 15 and 3, babalik tayo sa idea ng middle value. So, the middle value is actually just the sum of the components. Sabihin natin kasi y value yan, a vertical value, a vertical component. Y plus, y sub 1 plus y sub 2 all over 2. Also, kung sa ano naman, sa, sige, para ano na lang, para mas maintindihan. Gawin natin tong k. Yan. So, this is K. Ang H naman, syempre, ang H, X naman yung kanyang ano, gagamitin. We have X sub 1 plus X sub 2. All over 2. So, subukan nyo. Negative 6 plus negative 6, di ba? Negative 12. Negative 12 divided by 2. Negative 6. Okay, so, tama, yung H component natin, negative 6. How about K? K, So tingnan niyo yung ano, tingnan niyo yung y component or vertical component. We have 15 and 3. So for our k, we have 15 plus 3 all over 2. So 15 plus 3 is 18. 18 over 2 is 9. So our k is actually 9. So if we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So somewhere here, oops, hindi na straight. Somewhere here ang center. And that is negative 6, 9. Naka-follow pa ba? Like na kung naka-follow. So ito ha, ito na yung formulas. Middle value yan. Middle value ng k, middle value ng ano ng any. For example, kung foci ang given, just get the vertical component divided by 2. Just get the horizontal component divided by 2. Kung ano siya, vertices, ganun pa rin. Same yung idea. Kung co-vertices, ganun pa rin. Same yung idea. Just find the middle values. Okay, so yan. Meron tayong h and k. And since we have these 4, we can solve for the standard equation. Okay, so standard equation natin, vertical, it's y minus k quantity squared over a squared. Siya yung first term, followed by the next. Okay, then substitute lang natin. Okay, if we simplify this, we will get y minus 9 quantity squared over 16 minus x plus 6 quantity squared over 20 equals 1. So plus siya kasi negative times negative. Okay, 2 square root of 5 quantity squared. So if we distribute to 2 squared is 4, cancel yung square root, so 5 yan. So 4 times 5, that's 20. Or you can use your calculator. Okay, so let's have the last example. Last example for today. So paano naman kung real world situation or real world scenario? So let's read this example. The design layout of a cooling tower. So cooling tower, it's a tower used to used for the exhaust of extreme heats. So for example, sa extreme heat, for example, sa nuclear energy or sa geothermal energy, ginagamit siya. Okay, so baka nagtataka kayo, baka akala nyo yan ay storage. No, hindi siya storage. Ang purpose ng reactor is, syempre, from the term reactor, dyan nagkakaroon ng reaction and yung heat, nilalabas niya efficiently. That's the purpose of a reactor. Para hindi siya kumalat sa environment basta-basta. So, magandang ano, magandang structure ang hyperbola for that extreme temperature. So, the tower stands 179.6 meters from the ground. Ala-ala.
Ako, mag-ilong.
Paki ano, paki-mute.
Yeah. Atayo niya, kay ba mo, ano, construction sa buong? Dahil lagi nung useless na.
Okay. Okay, so let's go back. Sige, huwag na lang natin aduhin kasi baka para hindi mapansin. Sige, okay na. Na-blooper lang tayo. So, 179.6 meters tall ang total height ng tower. Okay. So, the diameter of the top is 72 meters. So, ito yung top. So, syempre, naka-side view tayo. So, yan yung nakikita natin. At the closest, the sides of the tower are 60 meters apart. So, ito. Okay. Approximate the equation of the hyperbola that models the sides of the cooling tower. So, may nakalagay dito approximate. So, ibig sabihin, baka meron tayong rounding off na mangyayari sa equation. So, hindi siya perfectly na exact talaga na, ano, na equation. So, sige lang, check natin later on. So, assume that the center of the hyperbola indicated by the intersection dash perpendicular lines in the figure is the origin of the coordinate plane. So, ano ibig sabihin yan? So, yung ano daw, yung daong perpendicular na dash line, which is ito, at saka ito, ito lang naman yung dash line dito. So, they are actually the x and y axis. Nasa origin eh. Siyempre, nasa origin. So, ang center natin, nasa origin. Okay? So, okay. Usually, in a real life situation, nagkakaroon talaga ng tinatawag nating reference. So, the when we call the term reference is associated with the Cartesian plane. Okay, so iba din yung reference na ano na itsura, 'di ba, yung mismong form, but pag sinabing give me the reference tapos computation ang pinag-uusapan, likely ang starting point niya nasa ano siya, nasa Cartesian plane. So here is the center. Okay, so alam natin center is 0, 0. So kung 0, 0 yung center, meron tayong h kaagad at saka k. Alam na natin na may h and k. So ang poproblemahin na lang natin is a and b. Okay, so let's try. So first, syempre, from the drawing itself, hindi naman siya pataas or pababa, it's left and right ang ating sides ng nuclear tower or nuclear reactor cooling tower. So our TA, transverse axis or the axis of symmetry, it's horizontal. So this give you the idea na ito yung formula na gagamitin, x minus h quantity squared over. Okay, next. Always take note that you are referencing the Cartesian plane. So meaning may mga mahahati dito na values. So for example, oops, hindi siya straight. Dali lang. Hindi ako pakali kung di straight yan. Yan. Okay. Ibig sabihin, may mga mahahati na values. For example, ang 72, we need to divide this into two parts. May going to the left at saka meron din going to the right. Baliktad, right pala at saka left. Okay, so we have 36 na dito, 36 meters. Ito din 36 din. Ano pa? Meron din tayong 60. Yung 60, mahahati siya into two parts. We have 30 here. And of course, 30 din dito. Naka-follow ba? Naintindihan kung bakit hinati? Hahatiin yan basta pag Cartesian plane. So, bakit natin hahatiin? Kasi location. Cartesian plane always indicates location. So, we need to divide these distances in terms of the Cartesian plane so that we can locate certain points. Okay? So, of course, we have the center, 0, 0, indicating that h is 0 and k is 0. Okay, so saan natin nahanapin ngayon si A at saka si B? Yun ang naman ang kulang natin eh. So si A, it's always, so kung ang center natin is all nasa 0, 0, ibig sabihin, itong 30 meters, itong 60 meters pala, sorry, itong total ito, itong 60 meters, that's the length of the transverse axis, indicating that 2A is actually 60. And thus, A is 30. Okay, so yan, nakikita nyo, may 30 dito. Yan, ano pala siya? A pala yan. So, meron tayong A. Okay, may H ka, may K ka, may A ka. So, check natin, may C ba? Walang C. Unfortunately, wala tayong C dito. Walang focal, walang focus eh. Di ba, usually ang focus nandito dito, nasa labas na. So, walang binigay na focus. Ngayon, dito lang po problema tayo kasi wala tayong focal distance, walang focus. It means that we're going to use another given from the drawing. So hindi tayo mag-i-stick doon sa ano, sa conventional na given. So if you remember sa parabola, merong idea na hahanapin yung point sa top of the tower. So same goes here kasi meron tayong mga given dito. So may 79.6 at saka merong 36. So in reality, if I plot a point here, so again, nasa Cartesian plane tayo ha, imagine nyo nasa Cartesian plane, I plot a point here, nasa ano siya, it's a point on the parabola, I'll have a point of 36, kasi yung ating horizontal component is 36, and yung y component niya is 79.6. Okay, so it means I have a value of x, which is 36, and a value of y, which is 79.6. So kaya may, ano, may sub-zero, ibig sabihin, it's a specific point of x and y. Nagets ba? Like daw kung nagets niyo. Nakafollow ba kayo? Nakafollow kayo sa solution. So, since wala tayong C, wala tayong ano, B, we need to find a way na makakasolve tayo ng B without using C. So, ang nakita nating paraan is yung point X and Y. What if X and Y yung ating hanapin sa drawing? So, yun, nakakita tayo ng X and Y. Okay, now, bakit kailangan yung X and Y? Kasi alam natin yung equation. So the equation uses these x minus h quantity squared over a squared minus y minus k quantity squared over b squared equals 1. So if I have h, I have k, I have a, I have x, and y. So pwede ko i-substitute dito lahat yan. And the matitirang unknown value is b. Diba? So magkakaroon tayo ng ganito. So it means that we can solve for b given the specific point here. So we have 36 minus 0 quantity squared over 30 squared minus 79.6 minus 0 quantity squared over b squared equals 1. So using our calculators, ito is actually, hindi ko nalang ipapakita yung calculator ha. Yan ay 36 over 25. You try to input that in the calculator. 36 over 25 ang answer niyan. Ito namang 79.6 minus 0 squared, that's 6336.16. Okay, so exact value pa yan. Hindi pa yan ano, hindi pa yan rounded off. O, para ma-check natin. 79.6 squared. Exact value yan. 6336.16. Walang rounding off na nangyari. Okay, then we are trying to solve for B, di ba? We're trying to solve for B. So, lipat natin si 36 over 25. So, we have negative 6336.16 over B squared equals 1 minus 36 over 25. Let's simplify 1 minus 36 over 25. That's negative 11 over 25. So, negative sila both sides. Take note. So, pwede ko i-cancel to by multiplying negative 1. Both sides. So, mawawala na yung negative. Magiging positive na yan. Okay, naka-follow pa? Naka-follow sa solution? Like na ako, naka-follow pa until here. Okay, very good. So, yun ang practice kayo mag-solve ng equation talaga. So, hindi pa tayo tapos. So, we want to have the b, yung b squared, dapat nasa numerator siya. Kasi hindi yung masosolve to kung nasa denominator siya. So, ano yung gagawin natin? Ang gagawin natin, we will multiply both sides by b squared. So parang yung kanina. Nagsosolve tayo ng equation. Nagka-cancel ka ng denominator, di ba? So mangyayari, makakancel na tong b squared dito saka ito. So, matitira, 6336.16 equals 11 over 25 b squared. So, malapit na. I just need to isolate b squared dito sa right side. So, para ma-isolate siya, I will multiply again by 20. Gusto ko mawala yung 25 dito, di ba? So, I'll multiply again by 25. However, gusto ko ma-isolate si b squared. So, pwede ko din i-multiply yung 11 over 11 para ma-cancel yung 11. So both sides din yan. Kung ano yung ginawa mo sa left side, yun ang gagawin sa right side. So maka-cancel out yung 25 here and yung 11 here. So you will have, okay, so sinu-cut na pala. So you will have 6336.16 times 25 over 11 sa left side. This will give us 158404 over 11. So check natin sa decimal. Kung decimal yung gagamitin ko, dapat isulat ko to lahat para exact value. However, hindi ko pwedeng isulat yung 0.36 lang. 14400.36 kasi magra-round off na yan. So to avoid rounding off, I will just use this. Yung fraction, para walang rounding off pa mangyayari. So we have 158404 over 11 equals b squared. Malapit na tayo. So na-cancel out ng 1125, di ba? So if we get the square root of this, check natin. So ang lumalabas, kunin natin yung square root niya. So ang lumalabas na answer is 120.00. So meaning, ito pala yung point, or rather, ito pala yung part ng solution na merong approximation na nangyari. Kasi tingnan nyo, take note. Wala tayong choice eh. Wala tayong choice. Kasi kung gagamitin natin to, itong square root of 158404 over 11, very convoluted yung equation. Diba? Isipin mo, ilalagay nyo yan dito. Malaki masyado. Masyadong malaki yung ano, space na makukuha. So, ang gusto lang kasi natin is an approximation of the equation. So, take note. Balikan natin yung word problem, ha? Approximate the equation. So, ibig sabihin, yung approximate pala na part, it appears on B. In solving B. So, solving B, this gives us an approximated value of 120. Nagets ba? Like daw kung nagets ninyo. Kung bakit 120 yung sagot. Okay, very good. Kung nagets. So, yun kaya may nakalagay doon, approximate the equation. So, ibig sabihin, may component pala na approximated yung value. So, we did not use this, square root of 158404 over 11, kasi convoluted na masyado yung value. And, doon pumasok yung idea na i-approximate lang siya. So, very clean kasi yung 120. And if you try to look at the solution or the answer, ang error lang niya is 0.0015. That's actually ilang percent? 0.1% ang error. Di ba? Kung 0.0015 yun, 0. So, if ating times 100, ang error lang niya is 0.015. So may 0.15% na 0.15% ta, hindi 15%, 0.15% na error. So kaunti lang, very very small, approximated siya. So using these values, may A na tayo, may B na tayo, may H and K. So we substitute again these values except for the X and Y para makuha natin yung equation. So you will have an approximated equation of the hyperbolic structure of x squared over 900 minus y squared over 14,400 equals 1. So yun, nakuha na natin yung equation ng nuclear reactor. Char, mga ano na tayo, mga engineers na tayo. Char, engineer na kagad. Yun lang. Isang side lang yun, by the way. Kung talaga gagawa ka ng structure, madami yan. Hindi lang isang parts. Okay, so, pero interesting kasi alam na natin, di ba, yung equation. So, check natin yung equation. Ito yung equation. Okay, so basically, kung kayo yung gagawa, for example, CAD, AutoCAD. AutoCAD, di ba? Itatype nyo itong equation na yun. Bibigyan ka ng ganito. Tapos, meron tayong mga values dito, di ba? For example, ito yung ground. So, paano natin malalaman yung ground from this? How do we recreate the ground here? So, basically, kung ito yung x-axis, nahati yung 179.6, di ba? And we know this part is 79.6. So, mag-ailan to? Anong value nito? Anybody, anong value nito? Type nyo daw sa chat. Anong value nito? This is 179.6 minus this
100 meters.
Okay, very good. 100 meters. Okay, but this is going down below the x-axis. So that's actually negative 100 itong part na to. So sa itong line na to, itong horizontal line na to, this is negative 100. So specifically, nandito yon yung ground. Dito siya. So y equals negative 100. Nakikita ba nyo yung ground? Ito yung ground. Okay. So yan, may ground. Paano naman yung top? So yung top, the same yung idea. Kung 79.6 meters siya dito, so that's actually y equals, so going upwards, so take note, up, taas, nasa taas siya ng x-axis, so that's 79.6, so y equals 79.6. So yun, sa AutoCAD, may option, like for example, if you want to cut this part here, matitira na lang, ito, at saka ito. So actually, ito yung shape ng ating nuclear reactor. Char, mga ano tayo, mga engineers sa tayo, oh. So, hindi accurate nila ganito pala talaga itsura. Ang itsura niya is paganyan. Parang, okay, paganyan yung itsura. Based sa equation, ha? Okay, so ito. Siguro may ano lang, may parang dagdag lang siguro dito na structure. Kaya mukha siyang ganito. But in reality, ito yung itsura niya. Yan. Okay?